Okay, let's tackle a process costing problem using the weighted average method, but with beginning inventory. So the odd part about the weighted average method is that the costs associated with that beginning inventory will be averaged in with our costs this month. But the beginning inventory will be ignored as far as equivalent units worth of work goes. So this is the average weighted average method. It's the most common used. Let's take a run at one. So LL Brewhaha makes beer in a two-step process. We're going to be in the first process. That's where barley, hops, and wheat are added to water. All the direct materials get added at the beginning of the process, so as soon as we start on something, it's complete as far as materials go. Conversion costs are added evenly throughout the process. Then we move the stuff onto the second process, where beer is bottled and packaged. So at the beginning of June, there were 100,000 units in beginning work in process in our department. Those units were 100% complete as far as materials go because materials are added at the beginning of the process. Once we start on them, they're 100% complete as far as materials go. And those units are carrying $100,000 cost for materials. Those 100,000 units in beginning inventory were 60% complete as far as conversion costs go. And they have accumulated $120,000 of costs thus far. So during June, they give us another 500,000 units. We transfer out 400,000 units. And the units that are left, which would be 200,000 units, are 50% complete as to conversion costs. Our costs that we had in June are $500,000 for materials, $100,000 for labor, and $800,000 for overhead. So in terms of T counts, here's our beginning work in process left over from last month. The $100,000 is for materials, the $120,000 is for conversion costs. Here's the new cost we added this month, $500,000 for materials and $900,000 for conversion costs. Our job as accountants is to figure out how many dollars moved to work in process bottling with the 400,000 units that we transferred out and how many dollars stayed. The first thing it asks us is about equivalent units for materials and for conversion costs. And this is where it gets a little odd. The formula is simply units transferred out plus units remaining in ending inventory. So the formula is units completed and transferred out plus equivalent units worth of work in ending inventory gives us total equivalent units of production. And we have to look at it from the point of view of direct materials and from conversion. The facts in this problem tell us we transferred out 400,000 units. 200,000 units are in ending work in process, and they're 100% complete as far as materials go. Because remember, once we start on them, there are no more materials to add. So that means our equivalent units worth of work for the month of June is 600,000. For conversion costs, the formula is the same. Units transferred out, 400,000, plus equivalent units worth of work left in ending inventory. There are 200,000 units left. We had 600,000 we were in charge of. We moved out 400,000. So 200,000 are left. They're half done as far as conversion costs, 50% complete. So 200,000 units that are 50% complete are the same as 100,000 complete units. So our equivalent units worth of work for conversion costs is the 400,000 plus the 100,000 or 500,000. Next, the problem wants to know the cost per unit for direct materials. We'll take last month's beginning inventory, add it to this month's work that we did, and divide it by the equivalent units of work that we did. So the costs from last month were 100,000. The new cost that we added as far as materials go was 500,000. So $600,000 worth of cost divided by 600,000 equivalent units means that our cost per unit for direct materials is a dollar. Next, the problem wants to know our cost per unit for conversion costs. So why don't you pause this video and see if you can figure out what the cost per unit for conversion costs is, remembering that we add last month's conversion costs into this month's costs and then divide it by the equivalent units worth of work we did this month. I hope you got it. Last month's conversion costs were $120,000. We add them to this month's conversion costs of $900,000. So they get averaged in. That's where the weighted average comes from. So $120,000 plus $100,000 plus $800,000 divided by 500,000 equivalent units worth of work, that's how much work we did as far as conversion costs go, means that it cost us $2.04 for conversion costs. Next, the problem wants to know how many dollars. Move on to the next process. Well, it's a dollar for materials and $2.04 for conversion costs. So that means this month it costs us $3.04 to make a unit. $3.04 times the 400,000 units that went out means that 1,216,000 moves on to the next process. So we credit work in process brewing and debit work in process bottling for 1,216,000. Again, that's $3.04 a unit times the 400,000 units. And the last question is, how many dollars stayed in ending work in process? The simplest way to answer that question is to say, if our total costs here are 1,620,000 and we transferred out 1,216,000, that means the balance must be 404,000. But let's prove it by pricing out that ending work in process in the brewing department. There are 200,000 physical units left. They are 100% complete as far as materials go. Materials cost us $1 per unit. So 200,000 times $1 a unit. Those 200,000 units are 50% complete as far as conversion costs go. So 200,000 units that are 50% complete are the same as 100,000 complete units. Our conversion cost is $2.04 a unit. So 100,000 times 2.04. And you do that arithmetic, and you get the 404,000. So the challenge of this method is that the costs from last month get included in our calculations for this month. But the work that we did to finish up those units does not get included in our calculation. That's why we call it the weighted average, because last month's costs get lumped in with this month's costs. And that problem gets fixed in the FIFO method, which is a lot more complex to do, which is why most people just use the weighted average method. Hope that helps.